everybody, this is Dave Vellante, and welcome to theCUBE's coverage here. This is NYSE and theCUBE AI Robotics Week. We've taken it to poolside here near Portola Valley. We're at the Rosewood. It's beautiful out here. The weather's great. Really excited to have Matt McClernan on. He's the Chief Revenue Officer of Augment Code. What a great name, Matt. Thanks for coming on.
Yeah, thanks. I wish I could take credit for the name.
Well, I mean, it's kind of the hottest trend right now when people ask, well, I'm not really getting value out of AI, ROI is not there, but it's definitely there when it comes to coding. Tell us about Augment Code.
Yeah, so we were founded in the summer of 22, and our goal, so we are in the AI coding assistance space, our goal was to help enterprise software developers with AI, facilitate the work on complex code bases. So it's quite different than a lot of the competition in the space that are generally focused on just generating code. Our focus is on giving developers the experience of working with a peer that's a senior software engineer working on that code base with that sort of knowledge. So we went GA with the product in November, and we're seeing really good traction since.
Okay, so the philosophy is human in the loop, senior human in the loop,
yes,
with a less senior developer, and using AI, human plus AI, drives the value.
Exactly.
So CRO, well, first of all, what's your background?
Most recently, I was with MongoDB, so I'll spare you kind of the history of it, but I'd say I was with MongoDB. I was fortunate to be on a nice run with them as we were, kind of pre-IPO, post-IPO, and learned how to really sell to the developer market.
Yeah, nice. So, so when we think about, code augmentation, we had Mark Benioff on a little while ago, and when I was prepping for the interview, I was watching a bunch of podcasts and things, and he was saying that they were seeing like a 30% productivity improvement in their coding. And then by the time he came on our podcast, it was up to 50%. And he says, we're not stopping. You saw Andy Jassy today or yesterday talk about how AI is going to dramatically change the productivity of their organization. You're seeing large companies like IBM. I mean, hiring is relatively flat. Coding is an area that is now being supercharged. So how are you guys taking advantage of all those trends? And what's the sort of North Star for?
Fortunately, the major trend right now is every organization seems to accept they need some form of AI coding assistance in their organization, right? So I'd say it really, there's a broad spectrum of how we take advantage of those trends with companies that are looking to really, create a larger niche in the market. Obviously, they're looking at a product like ours to produce iterations on an existing product, and with larger organizations, they're looking to, break down a really old code base and enable themselves to move faster, right? So we see the space where we think that there's going to continue to be more hiring of software engineers and sort of leveling up of the sort of productivity we're seeing from developers.
As a CRO, CRO's one of the most important hires. You get your initial engineering team, you get product market fit. I don't know if you have product market fit. Do you feel like you have product market fit?
Yeah, we do.
You do? Okay, so now it's time to scale the go-to-market.
Yes.
I mean, a lot of startups, they make a mistake. They try to scale go-to-market before they have product market fit.
Right.
They don't even know what they're, what they're trying to solve for.
That's right.
So you've got that. But my question is, how do you think about AI, applying AI from a go-to-market standpoint? How is that changing the way you think about it? You obviously got experience with Mongo pre-IPO. Dave's done an amazing job there. Great company. We've done their shows a number of times. But how do you think about the changes that are coming in sales as a result of AI?
Well, we're in an interesting situation, specifically at Augment Code. In the space we're in, we're seeing such a gravitational pull and such an appetite in the market. It's driving tremendous top-line growth. And so it's putting us in this position where I say there isn't a traditional sort of blueprint we can lean on to scale a go-to-market organization. And so out of necessity, it causes us to think about different ways to support that type of growth and demand. And so, of course, as you acknowledge, like we're an AI company, so we're inclined to figure out ways to use it. But we're forced to figure out how do we serve a growing customer base that's growing by tens of thousands, on like a monthly basis. So there's natural areas of thinking like, okay, from a customer success standpoint, how can we use AI to address like really simple basic questions that are commonly coming up? How can we use AI to follow up with customers that maybe are not using our product as frequently as they once were? So there's just so many different areas to think about how can we get things done with AI first so that we can ensure that, you know, we're being smart about adding humans across the globe.
Well, just like your approach in coding is to pair up a senior person with a junior person, presumably the role of the BDR is evolving quite dramatically. How emails are written, how to follow up, what the next best action is.
Yep.
How are you seeing that relationship? And what have you learned from your actual your product that you can bring to sales?
Yeah, I'd say we're still figuring that out. Yeah, real time figuring that out. There's still value in having that human touch.
Yep.
You know, there's explosive growth in that space of SDR, BDR, assisted AI products. But I think like the perspective we're gaining is that still individuals, humans, want to buy from humans. And they can sense when they're getting interaction with an AI BDR. And so we're looking more and more about how do we sort of like couple that sort of deep understanding of how a customer might be using our product with AI with a person that they can build a relationship with.
How about the relationship between marketing and sales? How is that changing? What do you need from the marketing, you know, department, if you will? And how is AI changing the potential there?
Yeah. Marketing's evolving really rapidly, and we're in the dev tool space, right? So developers are very religious about the products that they're using, and it's very much word of mouth and hype and excitement, you know, and typically it's like, if there's some new exciting technology, developers will talk about it in various communities, and you'll see a kind of a surge in the growth of these products. So I'd say from a marketing perspective, it's much more thoughtful around engaging different communities, community influencers, and sort of finding moments, one, to celebrate, you know, advances in your product and doing it on a cadence with some frequency. So I find that the alignment between marketing and your product teams needs to be really tight. We need to understand from a marketing perspective when we're going to have that next big release or feature. It has to happen frequently. We have to prepare the community and the influencers to be able to broadcast that message. And then for us, with a self-serve type of product as well, that then results in a lot of top-of-funnel interest.
Are you hiring?
Yeah.
What's your like ideal hire? And then I want to ask about your ICP.
It depends on the function, right? We're hiring across all aspects of go-to-market at this point. I'd say, it's ideally folks that have sold to developers before, software engineers. They understand the persona and the nuances and helping facilitate access to a product like ours, because developers are they want to get their hands on a product and they'll make that decision themselves. So people that understand that sale, and that's not just sellers, it's in marketing, it's in folks that are figuring out on the support side how to facilitate these communities to support each other. And then that's really North America for the moment, but we're quickly looking to EMEA, we're looking to APAC, because we're seeing huge developer demand out of those.
And your ideal customer is obviously a developer, but is there a particular nuance in the persona that you're targeting?
Yeah, we find that the more senior, more experienced developers are the ones that are drawn most commonly to Augment, because they value the context awareness our product has on their complex code base. So it's those folks, and I'd say, you know, it's very senior level leaders, CTOs, SVPs of engineering.
Matt, thanks so much for
coming
on theCUBE. Really appreciate it.
Yeah.
All right, keep it right there for more action from the Rosewood. This is Dave Vellante for John Furrier, the whole CUBE team, NYSC Wired plus theCUBE, AI Robotics Week. Keep it right there, right back, right after this short break.